If you've never experienced virtual reality before, then the Vive is definitely the best way to take your first trip. Sounds like a drug. Consumer virtual reality is finally here, and if you want the best experience right now, you're going to want to pick up the HTC Vive. The biggest blessing and curse of the Vive is that, unlike the Oculus Rift, you can actually walk around a few feet in virtual reality within what's called the play space. First time setup is not a particularly elegant process, requiring an area big enough and laced with enough power points to run the Vive's headset and its base stations, which in turn need to be placed on top of furniture, mounted on tripods or screwed into your walls. The whole process takes around 20 minutes, depending on how much adjusting and cable routing you need to do. Like the two developer versions before it, the finished product adopts the same bulbous insect eye-like appearance, covered in tracking points and a centrally positioned camera so you can see the outside world. It boasts plenty of room for head and eye adjustment, but it's also the most front-heavy of the bunch compared to the likes of the Oculus Rift and PlayStation VR. Unlike the Rift, the Vive doesn't pack integrated headphones, instead leaving you with a stereo jack to plug any cans of your choosing into, whilst the rest of the cables form a tether, which you'll inevitably step on or get tangled up in from time to time. The controllers are a big part of what helped the Vive experience really stand out. We'd have liked them a tad smaller, but they're intuitively designed and light enough to wield without issue, integrating several physical controls in easy reach of your fingers and thumbs, including a touchpad and grip buttons. Once the Vive's PC client and Steam VR are installed, you'll be able to get into the virtual space. There are already a wealth of titles with Vive support on Steam, and not just games. You'll find experiential, educational, and artistic offerings too. Virtual reality has attracted a lot of attention from the developer community, so we'd recommend that you check out some of the smaller experiences, as well as those from the big brands. The common theme across all of them is the amount of time you'll likely spend within those experiences. VR titles behave more like mobile apps, usually offering smaller, self-contained experiences as opposed to longer, more drawn-out narrative-driven content. That's not to say you'll spend 15 minutes with the Vive at a time, though. If a VR experience is particularly immersive, it's easy to spend hours exploring, playing, making, or creating and not even realize where the time went. If you've never experienced virtual reality before, then the Vive is definitely the best way to take your first trip. The laser-based tracking system means that your head and hand movements shadow your actions practically perfectly, and although tracking issues do crop up from time to time, they are pretty rare and often easy to fix. The Vive's lenses do a good job of offering clear detail at the center point of your vision. However, distortion is noticeable closer to the edges, as is the screen door effect despite the 2160 by 1200 resolution. The quality of your experience with the Vive also hinges on the power of the machine behind it, and we tested ours with an Asus G20 gaming PC running Windows 10 with an i7 processor, 16GB of RAM, and an Nvidia GTX 970, the lowest recommended graphics card for consumer VR. It offered a graphically sound experience, but those looking to build a rig of their own might want to consider the more powerful and power-efficient GTX 980 Ti, which will likely start to drop in price now that Nvidia's new GTX 1080 Ti is here. Every piece of the Vive hardware runs on mains power, with the exception of the motion controllers, which in our tests lasted around 5 hours before needing a recharge. To power each controller back up takes around an hour. There's definite room for improvement with the headset's weight distribution, resolution, controller battery life, and the fact that it's still a tethered experience to consider, but despite all these criticisms, there's also a lot of positives. The HTC Vive is the most immersive virtual reality experience money can buy right now, and if you have that money and the PC to support it, we'd recommend that you dive right in. Otherwise, waiting for Generation 2 might make more sense both technically and financially. Hopefully you enjoyed this video on the HTC Vive, and if you have any questions about the headset or virtual reality in general, you can drop us a line down below in the comments, and you can find out more on Recombu.com. Thanks for watching.